before I say something to the choir, I just want to thank my big daddies in the altar for the opportunity, starting from my dad that supersede every authority in the church right now, my dad Olorun Inshallah, and my daddy that's always been my daddy, my adopted biological father, my daddy Johnson, and every of my daddies here, I just want to say thank you. As much as I've tried to avoid this pulpit all the time, so I guess I couldn't avoid it today. And I want to really, really thank God for the spirit given to the choir, because each time they minister, it either it corroborates with what the ministers or what somebody's going to talk about. Today I'm going to be talking about the symbolic of an heir, the symbolic of an heir or a slave. The symbolic of an heir to the throne of all a slave. So they came up and they say something like, we are family, we are joint heir to the kingdom of God. So even before I start ministering, they started telling me that as if they knew the topic of my sermon. So I said that may the spirit of the Lord Jesus Christ will continue to shower, overshadow, and be upon your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I'm not going to be taking our time, so I want us to grab our Bible. If you don't have a Bible, you're not supposed to be here. So grab your Bible. Grab your Bible. I want us to... It's a church of God. It's funny, but it's a church of God. If you don't have a Bible, you can't go to school without your pen and paper. So this is a Bible. And we have a Bible, spare Bible. So I want you to... I'm going to be traveling fast. I want you to travel with me. I want you to go into the book of Isaiah chapter 50. And I want us to read it together. Verse 7. Isaiah 50, verse 7. Wait. I like the spirit. So I will say 1, 2, 3, and I want you to mean it. So let's go. For the Lord God will help me, therefore shall not be confounded. Therefore I've set my face like a flint, and I know that I shall not be ashamed. Praise the Lord. I want you to know that what you read, I want you to mean it. Like you really mean what you read. I said that I'm just talking about the symbolic of an heir. The essence of a Christian or the essence of being a celestial church members is not for you to flaunt your white garment. It's for you to understand the kingdom where you're going to. The essence of kingship, the essence of being a Christian is not because you are a brother, a sister, or you belong to celestial fold. Because there are so many churches that are Christian. So, we are all running towards the race. And the race is for the commonwealth of God. So, as a Christian, you need to understand who you belong to. You need to understand whether you belong to God, whether you are a slave, or whether you are the heir to the kingdom. Praise God.
Amen.
But when you mix them together, growing up, they might not be different. Yes. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So I want you to understand that coming into the presence of God, you need to understand who God is. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I'm not going to take any time, so I want you guys to like be with me. So first thing first, understand who you are. Understand who you are. Who has a child here? Who has a child here? I want to give you an analogy. If you bring your child to church and you are going home and your child followed another parent, what's going to happen? It's not possible, right? Oh, mom, where was the church? Let's say it's a 2-year-old. Even if the baby, they know their mom. So think about it like that. If your baby can understand you, and will not follow another person to home, don't you think it's ridiculous for you to be serving another God? You don't think so? So, if or more that you press fed and everything cannot go home with another parent. So you come, you claim who you claim to be, and you don't understand your dad. You don't understand the rulership you that's bestowed upon your head. You don't understand the sovereignty and the knowledge of the blessings you carry. Then you are like a child that is following another parent. Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
So I'm talking about the symbolic of an heir. You will either be an heir or you're a slave. There's two ways to it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because we serve a kingdom that is Christendom. We have a God that will not share his glory with anybody. And his rulership is from east, west, north, south, the nook and crannies of this world. And he has everything accrued to it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And by the fact that Jesus Christ was came to existence, he gave us the ownership and the authority and the opportunity to call ourselves, to call us child, and we can say, Abba, Father. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I'm going somewhere. So if you don't know who you are, then you need to understand why your prayers are not being answered. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
1 Peter 2:9. 1 Peter 2:9. And I want somebody to open Galatians 4:1. I'm traveling fast. 1 Peter 2:9, Galatians 4:1.
But ye are a chosen generation.
But ye are a chosen generation.
A royal priesthood.
A royal priesthood.
And holy nation.
And holy nation.
A peculiar people.
Praise God. Hallelujah, man. You are a chosen generation. One. So that means you should never, never compare yourself to your counterpart or to anybody that is your that you are competing with. Second, your chosen generation, a royal priesthood. That means the authority and the anointing you carry is not synonymous to anybody on the street. It's different. So you need to understand that. As a matter of fact, you need to know that if people fall down by your side and you are walking, you're different from them. Praise God. So, in everything you know, do you need to have that charisma. You're not being proud, but you're just understanding the God you follow. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Because you cannot. He said nobody can come to the Father without having a depth knowledge of who he is. Praise God. So, my second thing is that understand him after you understand yourself. But before you understand him, never compare your trials with anybody. Because if you do, you will mistakenly get him angry. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. I want somebody to open in the book of Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 3. It said, there is an appointed time for everything. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 3. And I still want somebody to open up Galatians 4 verse 1. Habakkuk 3.
For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Yes.
But at the end.
At the end.
It shall speak. And not lie.
Though it tarry.
Wait for it. Because it will surely come. It will not tarry.
Verse 4.
Behold. This soul which is lifted up is not upright in him.
Yes.
But the just.
Yeah.
Shall live by his faith.
The just shall live by faith. So you understood that you are a chosen generation. One. You understood the royal priesthood too, but you need to understand that your trials too are for specific time. They are temporary. Thank you, Daddy. You need to understand that every pains and storms and stresses of life you go through, they are just for the time being. See, the essence of life is not in never falling, it's rising when you fall. And you need to rise with Christ. Praise God. So, the symbolic of being an heir to the throne is to understand the person that sits upon the throne you are serving. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, if you as an heir to the throne, let me make you understand about the Queen of England now. So, the Queen of England, when they gave birth, that's an ordinary monarch. All their children are being tutelaged on how to become a queen or a king.
depending on whether they give birth, whether it's a son or a child or a daughter. So at that particular thing, the first son or the first daughter, they always tell them what to do, how to speak, how to do things, because they understand. They are not protecting that child, but they are protecting that kingdom that they sit upon. So for everything that child does, represents the kingdom. So all your actions, all your attitude, all your belief system, all your notions, all your ideology should reflect the kingdom of God. Praise God. So if that is contradictory to what you carry in your head, you can never see the full benefit of him. Praise God. So it's either you tap to him or you tap out. It's just simple. Praise God. So I'm not going to be taking time. Isaiah 54:1-2. Isaiah 54:1-2.
O brethren.
Yes.
Thou that did not bear.
Yeah, that's the lesson we read today.
Break forth into singing.
Yeah.
And cry aloud.
Yeah.
Thou that did not travel.
Yeah.
With child.
Yeah.
For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife.
And God bless you, ma. Mommy, I'm coming. I want to say something there. Even God is trying to tell you that never compare a problem with anybody. There are so many people in this world that you might want to be like them, but you don't know what they go through. They might have children, but it's out of wedlock. They might have the money, they're nursing it with cancer. Do you know what I'm trying to say? I'm not trying to say anything, I'm not wishing it, but I'm just letting us understand that you can never compare yourself, because the God that you serve seeth it from far, because he will never let any temptation overcome you. So don't compare your problem with anybody. You just need to hold fast. The third thing, understand that God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The King of Kings and the Lord of God, the Ancient of Days, the I Am that I Am, the only person that can reverse the irreversible, that can change the unchangeable, the all-sovereign. I don't think you understood what sovereign means. Is the Opa Opa Olua Olua. The book of Psalm 95 said, he is God above all gods. And we claim to be that God's child. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So if we are not fronting the blessings of that God, there's something wrong. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah 55:1-3. Psalm 24. I want you to read, because I'm talking about my daddy. Psalm 55:1-3. Yes.
Wherefore do ye spend money for that which is not bread?
Yes.
And your labor for that which satisfy not?
Yes.
Hearken diligently unto me.
Yes.
And eat ye that which is good.
Yes.
And let your soul.
Yes.
Incline your head.
Yes.
Incline your ear, and your soul shall live.
Yes.
And I will make an everlasting covenant with you.
Yes.
Even the sure mercies of David.
Amen. Even God is telling us that this is who I am. This is what I can give. This is only. See, there's nothing we can describe about this God. It's even making us to understand that if God is plenty, see, one, if you have it flaunted, even God is flaunting it to let us know that I've got what you need. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
He said, the head is of the Lord and the fullness thereof. The head and the tail that there is thereof. Psalm 24. We read that every day. See, this God is just a God that you need to understand in. So, but you cannot understand if you don't understand who you are. So, once you take the fact that you're no more a slave, then your head will start thinking. I don't want you guys to be distracted. I'll be accepting that in a minute. So, I just want you to understand one thing, the rudiment of God's kingdom. Know who you are. Know the benefit you are bestowed upon from birth. Then know how to claim it from that God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The reason why Galatians 4 came along, the lesson with the second lesson, I'm jumping onto the second lesson now, is because the people of Galatia are being stupid. They don't understand the fact that God is there, the blessing. They did not even understand God. So Paul was telling them, "Oh, you foolish Galatians, don't you know you are no more slaves?" So he came to chapter 4, he's now telling them that even the women of the bond woman, almost all been into a room, they cannot attain into that commonwealth of blessing. How much more? But you are no more a child. See, praise God.
Hallelujah.
At a particular point in our life, it is acceptable for us to behave like a child. At a particular point in our life. But it is going to be ridiculous for when we grow up to still act as a slave. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I don't think you understand what I'm trying to say. As a child, it's okay. At a particular point in our life, you can transgress. You can... Okay, let me give you a picture. I'm a magic kid. I'm a king. I'm a king. I'm a king. I'm a king. They might be playing mud together. They were a kid. It's acceptable. But when the time comes for them to go home, more lola, one what I'm trying to say is that Tobati Dagba, he can't do it anymore. Praise God. Praise God. You need to understand that a slavery mentality is when you have something in your hand and you're still going outside to beg. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I'm talking in allegory now. It's symbolic to what you have as a God. You can't have God and still looking something else. That was what happened to the Galatians. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You need to understand that Saul had God. He misused it. He couldn't understand God anymore because God stopped talking to him. He started begging. He had him. He lost him. When you start acting like a slave, do you think, okay, let's think about it. You as a mother, you've given your child everything. And he's still behaving like a prodigal son. What are you going to do? You abandon him because you've done everything you could do. So, every time you do things, think about it in a symbolic way to God. God is merciful, but we need to understand that even though he's merciful, there are times it's a two-edged sword. He said the word of God is like a two-edged sword. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So I want us to understand that this God is merciful, but we need to understand him. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I've been rounding up by saying, the only way that when we act like a child, not to act as a child again, is by Romans 12, by renewing our mind. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
It's okay. I said it's okay for us to be slave once. It's okay. It's acceptable. But we need to change our mindset, our thoughts, our thinking, and seek God for who he is and what he's capable of doing. He said it is above, he will do exceedingly above, beyond, above what you think and what you thought about. Look at it this way, you're thinking about a Bentley and he's telling you he's going to give you a plane. That's that God. So you're thinking about a Rolls Royce and he's saying, you know, come on, you're even thinking of me so low. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So that's the God. And we are stepping out of that realm to go look for something else. How ironical. Our slavery mentality. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
It's funny, but we all have that mentality. We forget what we have and we chase it up and down. Even though I'm talking about God, but this little mentality cut across our day-to-day activities. You have something gracious in your hand, you trash it, you start looking for something else. It cut across our daily activity. Let us say, okay, in God, we still do it naturally.
be it your husband, your wife, your education, you will have something precious. You trash it, you start looking for something else elsewhere. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
It's slavery mentality. The God that gave us a church will not come down to teach us how to manage it. The God that gave you a wife will not teach you how to control it, control her, or how to manage it, because he didn't tell you to start beating her. Do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
The God that gave you a husband will not come down how to respect him. You're the one running your mouth to disrespect him. Do you get what I'm trying to say? These are slavery mentality. You have those things and you are trashing it. It's the way we have to God too. We have God, we run away. And we blame ourselves, we blame God. We cannot blame God. Because God is there. It is always we. Praise God. So until we start changing that mentality and start thinking that, hang on a minute, I'm from the commonwealth of God. I don't belong there anymore. Like the book of Hebrews. Please, I'm rounding up. I want you to go to the book of Hebrews chapter 10. Chapter 10, verse 21.
And having an high priest over the house of God.
Yeah.
Let us draw near with a true heart.
Yeah.
In full assurance of faith.
Yeah.
Having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience.
Yeah.
And our bodies washed with pure water.
Yes.
Let us hold fast the profession of our faith.
Yes.
Without wavering.
Without wavering.
For he is faithful that promised.
Yes.
And let us consider one another to provoke.
Yes.
Unto love and to good works.
Yes.
Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves.
Yeah.
Together.
Yes.
As the manner of some is, but exhorting one another.
Praise God.
And so much the more as ye see the day approaching.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You need to understand the profession that you have. That you are joined here to the kingdom of God. Whether you're a nurse, it's a profession. You're a doctor, it's a profession. You're a lawyer, it's a profession. You're a realtor, it's a profession. But there's a profession that supersedes the profession you have, which is the profession of being a kingdom, a child towards the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
A patriarch. Hallelujah.
There's some better reason than my
I'm sorry.